Aaron Flores.
Andrew Whipple.
Lords of the Fallen.
Yeah.
So this is my monthly challenger selection that you were so gracious enough to give me on the podcast. Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Well, you know how big of a fan I am of the Souls series, and I guess games like this, I mean, Lords of the Fallen takes exactly from that formula, and I haven't played it. I haven't looked at it at all. I heard it had a ton of issues at launch, but they have since patched it all in. We downloaded a 5 gigabyte patch, to be precise. So, damn, I hope this game works.
I'm already annoyed that, like, the bristles on his fur are, like, moving, but he's not blinking.
Yeah. That's some pretty good lighting right there, though.
It is some pretty good lighting. I think a lot of it might be pre-rendered.
Probably. It doesn't matter, though. We're playing this. So, if you're unfamiliar with our monthly challenger selection, every month, Aaron and I will give a game to each other on a podcast, and we just have to play through it. We'll check in 4 times a month. The goal is really just to go through as much of it as we can. It's just our backlog stuff.
And if you can't finish the game, we have to eat a ghost chili pepper on camera.
Oh, that doesn't sound good.
Actually, that's not a bad idea.
All right, so magic type selection.
Already with the words.
Yeah, look at this.
And the info dumping.
And this is more of an informal type of feature. We're just doing this on our own time, so junk could happen. There could be a dog barking. There could be people getting murdered in the background. Aaron could just start
rapping freestyle.
He could. I wouldn't be opposed to it.
I've dropped bars on camera before.
Okay, so I'm just reading over this stuff right now. Have you played this at all, Aaron?
Me? No, but I always pick Squirtle in these kind of scenarios.
Squirtle, yeah, that's true.
I'm just saying, you throw green and red in my face.
I'm always an illusionist or things that can kind of just get you out of trouble.
You're gonna pick the Bulbasaur.
Wait, they're all clones. And Harkin, I guess, is the name of the main character. Increases
like
magic recovery,
out here.
Increases energy recovery. Moves in the shadow dimension, protective shell, a surrounding... Alright, so the second move is always defensive. So this is the... Yeah, Deception is kind of like the rogue class, it looks like. Copying your moves and repeating the damage you've done. Huh. So I always look at the final content that you can possibly get in situations like this, Aaron. And if it doesn't seem like it would be that useful to me, just with what I know for the game now, I try to stay away from it. See, like this eye for an eye. Enemy attacks are being revenged by stunning the opponent. That just
being
seems
revenged.
That seems strangely worded. I don't like to take damage in games like this, and I know you don't. So, already, I don't know, man. That's not seeming appealing to me.
Well, listen, you got 2 more choices, yep, according to that little slice to the left.
Yep, alright, so we've got...
I honestly would probably just pick the red one, because I like to be as brutish as possible. But that's just me. I know you like to be a little more cunning.
I do. But this is seeming pretty good. I like the whole mimic thing, where all the damage that I do, all of a sudden it gets inflicted again. That seems pretty good. Yeah, so let's go with that.
I've picked Soldier Class in every single Mass Effect game.
Have you? Okay.
Yep.
All right, so equipment selection.
Equipment selection, just pick good.
It seems odd that you can pick other things that don't go with... Because look, red for the warrior, green for the rogue, and blue for the mage. I'm always into that kind of style, shield and sword and magic, but I like to be deceptive. Set of daggers is simple but very fast. Yeah, I seriously don't know anything, so there could be some encumbrance. I don't know.
Yeah, we're going in this blind, as I mentioned before.
Well, because look, there's weight.
Oh, then that definitely confirms that there's an encumbrance system.
Yeah. Buckler. Okay. You know what? Let's be a little bit different. Let's pick one and then go with the other. Because, shoot, if you can do it, why not?
Yeah, I was going to say, they gave you that option. If they didn't want you to do it, they would have forced you into that position.
All right.
Summary, you're a dude.
So there it is.
So did you just make your own class by picking your armor class against your magic type?
Real quick, let's see. Rogues are... Alright, so that's just literally a rogue. The other one was executioner.
That's actually cool.
It's cool. And then this one's going to be raiders. Huh.
Huh, that's actually cool.
That's really neat. Yeah, I like that a lot. Okay.
All right. Plus 1 point to Lords of the Fallen.
There it is. All right, so we'll try and be quiet in the cutscenes too because, well, we don't know anything about this game either. So
I don't guarantee anything.
Yeah. Like I said, I know for a fact that this game had some serious issues when it first came out. I want to say that it just didn't run well. It had frame rate problems.
I didn't hear a lot about it. I heard it was nowhere as bad as people thought it would be.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to do some maintenance here.
Sure.
Your remote is totally dying.
I think it's going to just straight up die on me. Hopefully it doesn't. All right, let's see what happens.
Creator and destroyer of worlds. Hear my vow.
So already these cutscenes are more action-packed than anything the Souls series has ever thrown, but I already get the feeling that it is not nearly as mysterious since we know the name of our guy, and he is going for the Hammer of Zeus.
He is. Is he wearing the armor you told him to?
Yeah. Pretty cool.
Hear my vow. My vow of defiance.
Right, here comes Diablo. That's definitely Diablo. I wonder if this is different.
Like based on your abilities you pick?
I always like a game that allows you to really customize your class before it even begins. And it's neat that they just simplified it, but then they made it unique at the same time. But we'll see as the game gets going if that actually makes a difference.
It's a good looking game. I mean,
it does
I have
look
a feeling
good.
I don't think this is real time.
What do you mean?
Like the cutscenes.
This
don't...
is all CGI, for sure.
See, you've heard me.
I do like it when games, it looks like it's CGI, and then it pans down, and all of a sudden the game just starts. A different time, a different war. Alright, so everything we just saw actually has no meaning?
Meant nothing.
I wonder if it is still safe. Either way, our quest for Antanas nears a conclusion. I hope he's worth all the men we've lost on our way here.
Look like the in-game graphics, and it looks good.
It's a good-looking game. Yeah, I'm actually shocked, even though it came out a year ago and it is a PS4 exclusive game.
I actually pulled up the info right here, and it came out October 28th of last year.
Wow,
so it wasn't that long ago.
Wasn't that long ago? Yeah. Was it PS4 only, or is it out on the Xbone? We ought to get our hands on the Xbone one of these days.
Yeah, we need to. Came out on PC, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4.
I would love to see what the PC version of this looks like.
Rogar is quite challenging. To learn the basics, approach the Marauder just ahead of you using L. Okay. Wow, alright. So, an actual tutorial.
Tip, this strategy is very forgotten. Oh.
Huh. Alright, so this is the same way that you play in Dark Souls.
Yeah, I'm reading the controls here,
and I'm like,
as
yours, they can be staggered, like Murder Now. This is
perfect. It doesn't seem anything out of the ordinary. Yeah.
All right. And then press X, okay? All right, that's different. Excellent.
This is already done more explaining than every From Software game combined in the past 10 years.
That is pretty cool. So, the main difference it looks like is rolling. It's no longer circle. It's the X button, and that's kind of jarring. I wonder if I can actually change that. Let's check it out.
Kind of like how Halo has the, like, hey, here are the Call of Duty controls.
Yeah, subtitles. I always like a game that has those enabled automatically. And controller
layout. There you go.
Excellent. Okay, well. Alright, cycle your weapons, that's the same.
See what the names of the other ones are, because it just might be like a Dark Souls reference.
Yeah, well, so the big difference, it looks like the cycle spells is the circle button. See?
I would stick with the defaults.
Oh, look.
Oh, there
it is. Cycle spells is up here. Okay, that's way better. Because it's more. Yeah, okay.
It's Dark Souls.
That's excellent. And, did you see that? Objective screen. Talk to Caslow.
Good old Caslow. Everyone knows him. Seems like it has some weight to it.
It does, man. Because that's what I'm trying to get used to right now. I always find that it's excellent when a game understands the weight of its characters and movement.
Yeah, I was going to say, it looks like it has some weight to it, but he looks like a big dude.
Alright, so let's talk to this guy.
I remember when they showed this at E3. I'll shut up.
It's locked. Oh, so there's branching paths, yeah.
Where's you big stupid jellyfish?
You're still losing blood, Caslow. The rogue are good. I didn't let you out of prison to worry
just
about
got a rap
me.
Sheet.
Okay. I need you to stay alive.
You don't even know who he is. Why do you need him to stay alive? Death,
I will try to spare you the inconvenience of my death.
Okay.
The man we're looking for.
So still mysterious to start.
He's the leader of all humanity. If we find his gods, we'll
So Antanas is the leader of all humanity.
So far I've seen only corpses, no survivors. The Rogar have clearly breached the walls of the monastery.
Good voice acting, along with Dark Souls.
To protect his people. If he is alive,
that is something that series is not credited for, by the way.
It really isn't.
Yeah.
That's because so many people, like, so little people care. But, I mean, I guess it's... Since it's good, it goes under the radar.
To open this door, a switch perhaps, or a key.
All right, so right now, just at first, I'm impressed because I like a character that has a name. It's still mysterious, but there's an objective.
I like how he takes his hood off for cutscenes.
Yeah, the lighting seems cool. Yeah, he's all set for combat right now.
I want to say though, I feel like the frame rate's around like just under 30.
That's what it feels like right now.
Like it feels
but then
like
again, in the
a
beginning,
PC game that like you should probably turn down a couple of notches.
Yeah.
But still playable.
This might be an actual PC game. Like, you know, something that you'd probably want to just play on there. Oh god.
Oh, your guy swings so slow.
He does.
You just sat there. Also, it sounds really good, too.
Yeah,
like,
Summer
the sound of, like, the iron clanging off that dude's skull sounds pretty good.
So, apparently, that guy was blind.
He was blind?
Yeah, that's what they just said. Like, some enemies are blind. Oh, yes, you can still do that. Okay. That confirms it, though. The frame rate is not the best right now. All right, so I can attack with my shield. I can't sneak, but...
All right, you can charge a heavy attack, kind of like that one game. Tipped in. I got it's consistently beating into your head that you should lock on.
Yeah.
That totally means they have, like, play tests where people are like, oh, I didn't know you were supposed to keep locking on, man.
Yeah, and there's the XP. It's actually kind of cool. It tells you exactly how much, but souls were sort of the same thing. Alright, let's go down here real quick. Actually, there's a couple of them, so let's go over here first. Alright, well...
I don't know if that was a stealth kill. It is in me.
And it I earned a trophy. My skull. Let's see if it's if that's what it is. No. Find a note someone left behind. The bones
are moving. Oh, you just found an audio log.
I found an audio log. It does not feel like
poison in my veins. The lighting's really good.
It's incredible. Liquid darkness. We have seen with
others what happens next. Eyesight goes first. You're not going to go downstairs there?
I'm going to wait and see what's ahead. Brother William, Brother Peter and I won't let the disease take us. So this is apparently
a
disease.
I'm shocked this audio log is still going on.
Yeah, it is still going.
There it goes.
Really liking the stealth elements. And whatever that stuff is. Alright, so it looks like this is probably where I need to go. So I'm gonna go back here.
So you're just looking for a key right now, right?
Yeah. Alright, so they heard me running. That's not good.
They hear me running.
Yeah, so now this is just Dark Souls. Oh, and the backswing hit that guy, I think. It did not. Oh, he grabbed me because it was too low. Alright.
Yeah, dude just took a third of your health bar.
Yep. Definitely Dark Souls damage. Alright, so drinking a potion, may as well just do it, right? I'm gonna say...
Whatever button did it in Dark Souls.
Oh, so you can two-hand.
Square?
Well, normally it's... Yeah, there you go.
What button was it?
It was square, yeah. All right. I was used to Bloodborne. I was pressing triangle.
See, you gotta get down into Dark Souls mode, man. This game doesn't even know about Bloodborne.
It doesn't. Alright, so there wasn't anything down there. It was just dudes. I think, right?
Yeah, does that lead down there?
It is possible. Alright, so the other thing I want to test... Oh, another audio log.
The fire's on the horizon. Right. They lost brownie points on the audio logs. I beg you, be careful. Something evil is happening. I can feel that. You can always seek refuge here. There's a staircase to your right there. Whatever happens... There's some inscription on the floor.
Please, please, be safe.
Okay.
That's a challenge?
What's that mean? Okay, so every time that we kill a formidable opponent, this thing opens up. Interesting. So which means we're going to have a formidable one up there. So let's go down here first.
I'm in kind of awe of how good this game looks. Like the frame rate's kind of
It's shaky.
A little shaky, but it's playable. Yeah, you played enough. You know better than that. I was thinking too. I was like, oh, we know better than this.
There it is.
There's the key.
Let's go up here first. Because we can.
Alright, there's your formidable foe. His head is on fire. Just throwing that out there.
Yep. Be right there.
He's on the floor.
So I just knocked him down.
Continue hitting him. You're still taking damage when you block?
Just a little bit. Got him. Alright. Marauder Great Axe.
That was not the formidable foe.
Yeah, it was not. Okay.
So we have to go back to Caslow or Kelso, whatever.
Yeah, well, I just killed him, so let's see what's up here.
Another, even more formidable foe. Oh, you could just drop down there.
Actually, that's exactly
where we're supposed to be. Yeah, because that's where Caslow's at, right over there.
Yeah. Okay. I can't run in this game yet. But, again, with all the armor on me, I don't really think I could.
Hmm.
I could use some help. Here. This might be useful.
Okay.
What did he give you?
What's useful?
I found a key. What are you waiting for? Open the door.
Are you
so
skipping
that? So it's a
cutscene
just for that? Okay.
What's behind the door? You and Medivh, or whatever his name is, going in for a good time.
Man, this looks like a boss room.
That guy is about to get murdered in like 20 seconds, I guarantee it.
An ice beast? Creature composed of chaos itself.
Chaos priest.
Oh, man.
Oh, sweet. Satan.
Alright.
You know, I figured he'd show up about an hour in, but, you know.
Well, the enemies look really cool to start.
He looks like Lord Zedd.
I wish that was true. He was just Lord Zedd,
where
yeah.
He just has, like, muscles and no skin.
And the sweeping music. Oh! The first warden.
He's got, like, the dreadnought shield from Naxxramas.
Wow. Alright. So, I'm just getting used to this right now. There we go. Alright, so, when the enemy's defense seems to lower exponentially when he attacks. See, look at that. That's huge. And then it does nothing.
That was a good dodge.
Yeah. It's just really slow. There we go. Whoa!
Oh, he just attacked you with his ass.
Let's go ahead and... Too slow. Whoa. It's kind of neat, too, because it's all in tiers. Right. Oh, shoot. Well, that just takes all my stamina. I didn't actually take any damage.
I do like the way it has the numbers popping out. Dark Souls doesn't really do that. Like, it has it shows you right. The numbers and values and such, but not like an RPG.
Yeah. Oh man, that actually
that hurt.
That really hurt. Yeah. That doesn't do anything.
This actually looks tough. Like, this is supposed to kill you tough.
Probably.
But we gotta defy the man.
I'm gonna defy the man. Oh, he actually creates a whole thing. Alright.
I'm very bothered by the fact that he's not wearing shoes.
Oh! Good thing I put my shield up right there. The lighting, man, it's just...
This game, like, makes good use of Bloom, not bad use. I've seen a lot of bad uses of Bloom. Oh, you knocked his armor off, I'm gonna say. He had, like...
I have, yeah. Look at his health. It's all in tears. I'm actually gonna heal right here.
You can dodge out of your own heal, but you don't get the heal.
That's attention to detail right there.
Beat him till he's naked.
But my guy attacks so slow that I can only get one, like, real decent attack. Oh, a wake-up. I like the wake-up attack. I'm gonna use that a little bit more, I think.
This is a game I definitely, like, I would probably pick this up on Steam when it's on sale.
Yeah. Yeah, there it is. That's the secret attack.
Oh, you broke the shield?
Right there. Oh. Oh, he's done with the shield.
All right.
He's a water dancer now.
Alright, remember, he enrages at 15%. You know what you're doing.
Yeah, let's go ahead and do this.
Yeah, get the guaranteed kill on him. This looks cool.
Stamina back off. Yeah, oh, he's water dancing. He does it for like an hour.
He does it till he hits you with it.
Got him! Yeah! That was cool.
That looked a little tough.
Yeah, a little
bit. Like, he actually had to legitimately hang back and read what he was doing in order to react to it properly.
That was neat.
As a spectator here, this looks really cool.
It does.
And now you've
I don't know what's going on,
activated
but
your Tyrell powers, and you're going to jump into Diablo 3.
The first warden. Am I the first warden now?
We're the first warden now.
So that's a lord. Let's see. All right,
defeat first warden.
Defeat the first warden.
Now we have to go fight the second warden.
Let's go and get this.
Kalso is alone and wounded.
Find him before it's too late. So we're getting all this stuff, and I don't know what it means. You just run, it looks like, normally, which is cool. I don't know how this game deals with secrets. I know how it deals with
buddy's
cues.
Buddy's bleeding out over there.
Yeah, he'll be fine, though.
He'll be fine.
You know what we need to do?
He's a wizard. He knows magic and shit. What is that?
That's probably where I need to go. I'm going to stay away from it real quick.
Yeah, because, you know, this church needs some renovations.
Because, see, yeah, the frame rate's dropping huge right now. Okay, maybe I do need to hit that. I was going to go to see where that portal thing opened up, because that was definitely a formidable... Oh. Remains of
the ancient. It's like in the cutscene, it blew the magic, bro.
Oh,
like,
check it out. Yeah. If you're reading this.
I'm skimming it.
Huh. So this is like a life stone of sorts. I don't know what they're going to call it. But this is a drop point. So the more... Have you ever played Defense Grid?
No.
All right, so the more resources that you'd have in that game, you just get automatic resources. So it's kind of like interest. The more that you have, the more free money that you would get. And that's what this thing, whole thing is. Oh, and this thing fell out again, of course. Right. Controller charging again. So it says, storing the experience at Save Shards gets you a tribute and spell points. Hold either L2 to store experience towards spells or R2 to... Okay. Let's try it out. Let's just see what it is.
Tap the screen in.
Oh, wow.
Little attributes section right there.
So that's kind of cool.
Straight out of Dark Souls.
So we just bank it. But you have to choose which one you want to do. Okay. Huh. Alright, and there's the details. Push L. That's pretty cool. Alright, so it's just gonna keep going through it. Alright, neat. So, this is
a lot going on.
There's a lot going on, yeah, but still kind of cool. And it looks like these are the different things that you could start out with. So, I actually started off with prayer. Which, motionless clone that attracts enemy attention. Interesting. So we need 8 faith to increase it. I don't think that I have any faith yet.
So you're just going to bank it.
All shields have a special use that you can trigger with L2 because shields bash your opponents. Yeah, okay, so... Oh, shoot. Okay, so I did not bank my stuff. I just used it as a checkpoint. So we'll wait. So this is where I'll spawn from now on. So let's go ahead and let's bank the XP for attributes first.
Your faith is 12, dude.
What's that?
Your faith is 12.
Yeah. I think we have to do that towards spells. So I haven't done anything with spells yet. I'm going to bank my stuff towards XP. There we go. So I've got that. And you know what? We'll do one for spells too.
Left and right.
All right, so my current experience. What does it do? Alright, so I need to have 12, which I already have, but I can't actually use that one. So here's my inventory. There's a ton of stuff. Which isn't a bad thing. Navigating it's kind of weird, because you have to use the analog stick.
Oh yeah, that looks odd.
Alright, an unknown rune. It can only be revealed by a crafted rune forger. I guess we'll learn more about that later.
Yeah, I feel like the game's been doing a good job of explaining everything, so I imagine they'll explain it when it's time.
Yeah. That's why I don't want to do anything crazy yet. Oh, and here we go, though. So I've got the Defiance Hammer, which does a lot. This is like a whole Diablo thing, too. They've got like a
little... Yeah, they've got the letters already. Like, hey, it's perp.
Yeah, it's pretty neat. Physical block defense. I don't really care about that stuff, but... The Persistence, the Great Sword. So that is... I guess I can't use that for some reason?
I think you got it equipped?
I do, but look, it does physical damage minus 43.
So it might be kind of like in Dark Souls 2, where if you can wield a weapon, but
right,
if you didn't have the abilities, it was like greatly reduced.
Yeah. Let's see.
Yeah, strength requirement's 15.
Yep.
So you fail that pass, and you could still carry it, but you're...
Yeah, that's what it is.
You can't do anything like it. So, okay. Yeah, I want to say that was in Dark Souls.
Yep.
Where if you didn't have the weapon proficiency, you could still use it, but it was terrible.
Yeah, so I just don't have strength right now. So...
Yeah, your strength is 8, so you need to be at 15.
What is this?
Is there magic cards?
Yeah.
That's a Tarmogoyf. Flip it for maximum damage.
Yeah, it looks like there's just a ton of these things hidden around. Okay, but... How do I... Ah.
There you go. So you can go up once.
So health. So look at that. Health goes up. It says plus 12 if I do that.
Your luck is 1. Which is hilarious.
But I don't need to. I don't actually need to right now. I'm not going to bother with it. I just banked that stuff. I'm just going to go ahead. So I usually spend a decent amount of time just trying to understand mechanics and systems of games before I really start to... Just go out and do everything.
Yeah, which is very different from me. I'm a brute forcer. I will brute force a game.
Okay, so that's new. That's
smash
a new
the
area.
Coconut enough times at your face, it will.
I want to go back.
You got to find Calso. I want to see he got blown through that door.
Caslo, he did. He's here, but
is that like immolated corpse on the floor? Him.
I'm actually gonna go back though, because
you're a real friend.
Yeah.
It's like, hey, your friend just got like. Blown the fuck up.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, well, he'll be fine. He's a wizard.
Yeah. There's nothing else down there. But there's that portal thing. There it is.
And it's open now.
Alright, let's go in. This is cool.
This is really, like, I'm impressed.
Yeah, this is pretty
cool. I kind of gave you this game half on, like, I just want to shit on this game, but...
Whoa.
Alright, you're going to go fight Rom.
Maybe I'm going to go back.
No, don't head back. You already went there.
The
moment things look bad, open that chest.
I feel like I should have tested to see if it was a mimic.
You can take that.
Yeah, Dark Souls has conditioned me. I've been eaten too many times.
Surprisingly, none in Bloodborne.
Yeah.
But I was on edge the entire time. I didn't trust a single chest. Like, in the beginning of the game, but like right around, like, I'm a couple hours into this game, they're going to throw this at me eventually.
Huh. This is really cool. I feel like if I run out there...
This is really mysterious.
Yeah. You know what? I'm just going to do it.
And just like...
Oh, you start taking damage. Okay.
That's it?
That's it. It was just a place to get some treasures. But it's not the same thing every time, I believe. That's what it was saying. Really neat. In Dark Souls, they won't even tell you that there's treasure at all. I mean, I had to remember that was there, which is cool. And it doesn't look like I can go into my inventory either, switch anything, unless I go to one of those life stones. I will test that theory in just a second. Oh man, all the
everything
dudes are
respawned.
Back. Now that's not cool. I have to fight that thing up there again. I wonder if you can do a backstab animation. You want to test it?
Sure. Aren't some of these dudes blind anyway?
I think so, yeah.
He doesn't seem like he has the finesse to do something like that.
Yeah,
but
it really doesn't.
Seems like a bit of a... Bit of a fat ass, actually.
Each successive victory stacks on your chance for better loot and gradually increases experience. Ha! So, I really like that system. Are you reading that? So
skimming.
the more victories, as it says, it slowly starts to stack up for better chances to get loot every single time. Until, that is,
you
go to a save point. Or you store your experience. So the more things that you're just holding on to, the better chance for huge rewards. Hmm. That is kind of awesome.
Because it actually encourages you to play the risk versus reward thing.
That's right.
In a game like Dark Souls, me, I'm a coward.
I run
back at every moment I have.
And I can't blame you. Oh, I totally just did that.
It was just backstabbing?
Yeah, that was a backstab.
Do it again. It seemed really effective.
There it is.
He's just floating up there.
And he's dead.
Nope, because I think that animation totally missed.
That's actually kind of cool that it missed, though. Wow. I'm having a good time with this right now. Alright. Let's find this Caslow dude. Oh, that guy is totally back.
That's the boss?
No, that was the guy that I trained on.
Oh.
Alright, so where the hell did Caslow go?
Somewhere in here. He got, like, blown to some wall.
I mean, that's a place to go, right there. So he could have gotten blown through there. I don't think that he got thrown around here, but there's enemies. Yeah, the northern wing. I'll look around here real quick. As we were just messing with it.
Oh, they call it surprise attack?
Yep. And that's what it is. So did you see the XP meter? It said times 1.10.
Yeah, the multiplier's going up.
So it's... We've got a regular bullet storm.
Nutshot.
Soon after banishing the god, the three men that were known as the judges parted ways
forever.
That's
pretty freaking
cool.
Apart from
their common goal, they were very different in every possible way. Three statues were built for them on the square of the judges, displaying the distinct paths they had taken.
Yeah, your multiplier went from 1.1 to 1.12.
It did not look like I could take that.
Only a shard of heroes could make that heart.
Well, you got a whole set of armor.
Dead for the warrior. Tear it out. So I can't actually go into my inventory. Oh, wait.
But have you tried clicking the pad?
I always forget to press this button. And there it is. So what are the ghost? So I don't think I've picked up any health potions. Maybe they refill, like, every time.
Yeah, I want to say I didn't see you pick up anything either. That'd be cool, like, based on the amount of damage you do, you get one back or something like that.
Yeah. Alright. And then, here's some warrior armor. It looks like it's all the same, starting equipment. It's just the way that it looks.
You go up one defense point. Changes your face.
Yeah, well, why wouldn't you do this? Oh, it's because that has poison defense. Well, shoot. I'm just going to do that right now.
Yeah, put all that crap on.
Alright, acolytes. It regenerates spellcrafting powers, okay? Oh. Nothing in there. It's two more weight, but I mean,
I wonder how the weight works. It looks like maybe instead of encumbrance, it's just you can't carry anything over 17.
Maybe. Yeah. I think that's what it might be, which I would prefer.
All right, see, now you're over.
Yeah. Strength requirement 14. I couldn't use it anyway. And it's got a socket.
This is a weird combination of Diablo and
it is.
Dark Souls.
All right, let's keep going for a little bit, though. Let's find this Caslow person, then we'll see what happens from there.
I keep reading it as Kelso, but that's just because I'm illiterate. There goes another one of those bad mamma jammas over there.
So I'm trying to block and see exactly how the parrying system works.
Did they even mention anything about one?
They did. Alright. The only thing that's weird about the combat right now is that... There we go. Let's go ahead and drink this. See, so it's going to work against me right now just because I'm still experimenting. With that guy, what I ended up doing was I raised my shield just before it hit me, and he went into that stun animation.
Hmm.
Yeah, but it wasn't really working right there. Come on. This weapon's too slow. There's another audio log.
There's a lot of those.
What exactly were
the lords?
They wielded power beyond our understanding.
Are you going to get an audio log on top of your audio log?
The god. Anyone who tried to talk to them.
We can't hold such forces much longer.
It'd be funny if they just doubled on top of each other.
A place with walls.
I'm very alarmed at the rate you're finding these audio logs. There's a chest over to you, right?
There is. Do you see what it says? Keep an eye on your environment. There are multiple ways that a room can stay hidden to a careless man. A monk staff. So let's just make sure. Can we use the monk staff?
Who made this game?
CI. They're known for their sniper series.
Hmm.
Yeah. Alright, well, let's try this. New weapon.
That looks a little faster.
It does, yeah.
Do you have the proficiency to use it?
Mm-hmm. My damage actually increases with it. I was just seeing if there was some sort of secret right there.
I'm kind of glad they took that out in Bloodborne, because I'm not hacking away at every wall like a dumbass for the entirety of the game.
Doesn't this look like a secret to you?
Yeah, it's kind of got like this red glint to it.
I guess not, though. It looks like you can blow up the wall somehow.
Maybe it's worth coming back to later.
Oh, man. There's the fat roll.
Wow.
Yep, alright, so... Let's see if I can fix
that. Armor's
got
to go down.
Alright, that's fine. Alright, so we're back down to 10. All right.
There you go.
Oh,
that's
man.
More, that's way more nimble.
All right, so... a magic energy shard. Oh, you're gonna kick. Well, that was weird. Maybe I'm just crazy, but I mean, it did say in here to pay attention, so I have to assume that this is definitely a secret. Alright, well, let's just go find Caslow right now.
He's probably dead by now.
We'll see what's there. I feel like he would not be down here. Oh, wow.
Wow, that was cool.
Yeah.
Your multiplier is at 1.2 now.
And explodinated. So it's funny because it's actually slower. Kind of like with how combat works, it's a little more, it feels methodical.
That's not exactly a bad thing, though.
No. It is not.
You know, because it could be similar to the Souls games, but it could take a different direction. Whoa. That frame rate was at, like, around 7.
Yeah. I feel like I want to play this game on the PC.
I'm curious what the backstab bow is.
Yeah.
Pardon me, the surprise attack.
Me too, but I'm going to go back because I must have missed Caslow. Each boss fight can be won in a special way. You'll know by having a unique loot.
Huh. So it's like some Titan Souls crap where you had to like shoot the arrow through its eye?
Maybe.
Backstab him.
I mean, I may as well.
Is that it?
No. I'm really liking this. Oh, goodness.
Oh, he broke it off. He didn't do his thing like he did last time when he threw you on the floor.
All right. Doesn't look like I can... Oh, yeah, there we go. You can totally do the backstab stuff without stunning them. I'm curious to see what happens if you die.
She's just gonna go back to the boss room?
Yeah.
Look for Caslow.
Yeah, and we could probably just call it for the first one. Just... It's cool, though. It's really neat. So, yeah, I blocked at the last second. You saw that, right? Uh-oh. Might not survive.
You don't have any more potions, huh? You just ate a crystal.
I did. I should not. I probably shouldn't have done that. Oh. I did get one more health potion. May as well use it.
I feel like they're restoring over time.
If so, it's extremely slow. What the hell? Oh. I always
like
appreciate.
No problem landing that backstab.
No, it's good now. Oh, the camera just went crazy. And now I'm getting 57 XP from that guy. I like that system, Aaron. I really like it. And I don't think I went this way to start. Alright.
This is the boss room's on the right.
The boss room's right here. So I can just run through these now. That's weird. I've just become so powerful that now pews cannot hope to stand against me.
It's like in Gears of War where you just run and you just go through stuff and... Oh, what a tease.
What a tease, yeah. I wonder if that first boss fight can be won in a specific way. Alright, so am I just being stupid? Am I just not seeing Caslow? He was here, we saw him get blown through.
Did he get blown through the window?
No, he went through one of the doors. Dead dude. This is the northern wing.
Yeah, this is where we started.
Yeah.
These things keep coming. We fight back. There are too many of them. It's sickening to see them move.
Typically, I'd say that they don't. There's no reason that they would come back here.
It's like fire and death creeping up your nose. One of the creatures we were fighting spat on us. Saliva hit my eye. It burned. It burns deeper into me.
He's gone. Maybe it's in the next area. Either way. Oh, shoot.
Yeah, I have no clue where the dude could went.
Yeah, this is just the starting zone, so it's not...
There's a chest over there. Didn't look like it was opened.
Nice. Alright, well, he's clearly not in here, so that means that, just progression-wise, he should have gotten knocked through here. I thought that I explored everywhere, but... Maybe they just assumed that he went ahead? Is it crazy to think that?
Maybe?
Well, in any case... I think I'm good for right now. This is a real fun game. I'm definitely going to have to put some more time into this, without a doubt. I can just check out here real quick. What do you think?
Yeah, I think now's a good place to... We could check back in.
All right.
See where you're at. Maybe a couple hours later. Have you found Caslow yet?
Yeah.
Maybe Caslow is the final boss. You're fighting Caslow and his face explodes.
Maybe that's how it goes. I just wouldn't think that a wounded guy like that would just journey ahead for whatever reason.
maybe he got knocked through the window and he just got blown to literal.
Well, either way, I couldn't go anywhere else. Okay, so you totally can sprint.
You just hold the evade button.
You can save your progress without losing your bonus experience modifier. Just hold down L3 while using the checkpoint. Well, that didn't work. It said while using the checkpoint, which is exactly what I did. And all my potions and stuff came back, so that sucks. Alright, well, in any case, this is good for now. It's pretty cool, Aaron. I'm liking it.
Yeah, I'm really interested. Like, I kind of was like, hey, we should play this game, because, you know, I assumed that it was going to be straight-up knockoff, but it's actually got me really intrigued, because it's actually taking a lot of the things that exist in these previous Souls game and giving its own unique spin on it, and it definitely has a more straightforward presence and a premise as opposed to having everything lie in mystery. So it looks really cool. I'm probably going to play it as soon as you're done with it, or maybe even catch it on a Steam sale or something like that.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks for sitting in on my monthly challenger.